Citizens of Haven Springs, that was The Wednesday with Bomb Squad. Up next, a very special request from some chick.
Sure, I know.
Alex, right? I'm Steph.
Hey. Just seeing if you need food or anything.
Oh no, I'm good. Thanks though. Sorry I couldn't hang out at the record store. I've got some time now though if you want to chat.
Is that your shot? What is that?
This is Bedazzled Kiwi Schnapps. No one's ever ordered it, so Gabe's trying to get rid of it with the jukebox game.
What's a jukebox game?
It's like a short version of 20 questions, where you're trying to guess a song, guess wrong, you have to take the shot. Ryan and I are going to play. You want to take his place?
Dude, you're on.
Yes. So, I'll pick a song. You have 5 yes or no questions before you have to guess it.
Okay.
Got one. Jukebox is all yours. So, what do you want to ask me?
I should flip through these and see what might be good to ask. Are there people on the cover?
No. Yeah, no.
Is there an animal on the cover art?
No animals.
Ugh, too bad. Some of these are really cute.
I know, right?
Does the band name have a symbol in it? Like something that's not just a letter?
Oh. Yeah, it totally does.
Nice.
You've got 2 questions left.
Is the band name on the cover?
Yep. Last question.
Yeah, all right, I know. Does the song have a long title, like 4 words or more?
Yes.
Interesting.
That's your 5. Ready to guess?
Yeah. Let me look through one last time. Here's what I know. The band name does have a symbol in it. The song title is at least 4 words long. No animals on the cover. No people on the cover. The band name is on the cover.
Fuck. Nice one. Guess I'm drinking? Hey, thanks for playing. I'm really glad we did.
Me too. Is that record store inventory?
No, It's character stats. Do you know what a LARP is?
I've heard the term before.
Live-action roleplay. It's like a tabletop role-playing game, but acted out in real life. Costumes, foam weapons, beanbag spells. It's great.
Gabe was talking about a LARP with Ethan.
Yeah, it's next week. They're coming with me. It's their first time. I'm so excited. Would you ever want to join us sometime?
Sure, I'd try it. If you and Gabe both like it, it must be super fun.
Awesome.
So, you and Ryan hang out a lot?
All the time. Except when he ditches me for Gabe.
They went to get first aid.
Being a hero again. Ryan's always doing that. It's a Lucan family thing. Have you heard about Jed's rescue? It was a big deal. Back when he was a minor, he saved...
I can't imagine. Alex wants an earload of Haven trivia just now.
Sorry, Jed. He doesn't like to brag, but there's stuff about it all over the place if you look.
Interesting. I should get back to work.
Okay.
Aren't you, though?
What the fuck did you just say?
Ryan, back off.
Aw, oh, hell.
I'm just saying. I thought I heard that you
Mac,
were the one-
you shut the hell up.
No. No, go ahead. You got something to say, Mac? Let's fucking hear
Come
it.
Come on, guys. Don't make me intervene.
All right! Fine! As long as we're tossing around accusations, way I hear it, you're the guy who cut the rope.
I can find out what's really going on with Steph.
What are they called again?
Don't shit on my yard! They're amazing! Their guitarist has one arm.
Badass.
Dude, give it up. I already booked a bus ticket.
Wait, hear me out. One more game. If I win, you have to stay. If you win, I'll cover the ticket.
You just lost 50 bucks.
Here's to your new job at the station.
Oh, didn't I tell you? I'm not taking it. I move to Denver next week.
You what? Damn it, fucking overpowered blue meteor.
Aww, is your controller broken too?
We're playing until I win.
Then I'll be crashing here tonight.
Steph?
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting your new foosball champion, Gabe Chen.
Oh, you're the worst! Can't believe I have to stay in this stupid town.
I think we both know you could have beat me if you really wanted to. So you're welcome.
Bullshit.
I think I know enough to help her now. Still can't believe he's gone.
Yeah. He's the whole reason I'm still... I'm sorry, Alex. Don't mind me.
How about a quick match?
Did Gabe tell you we played?
I just had a hunch.
Yeah? Well, you're right. I don't really think it's a great time. Fine.
First to 5 points?
If you say so.
5 points! That's game!
Yep. Big shocker.
Oh, hey, at least you played your best.
I mean, that obviously wasn't my best.
No, I get it. I mean, this is a tough game. Requires skill, timing, and the will to be a champion.
Oh, is that how it is?
Wait, hold on. The crowd is really picking up on my energy.
Ah, we love you, Alex! Ah, Strip Socks!
Okay, fuck you. I want a rematch.
You're on.
Woo!
Shit.
Oh, that's a win.
I was actually trying that time. Okay, wait. Let's get serious. One more game. Winner takes title of Ultimate Foosball Champion.
I don't know.
Oh, come on. You know Gabe would be all about us playing like this.
Well, then it's settled.
Woo! Foosball champion! Foosball champion!
Goddamn shit, family! Oh!
Good game.
Thanks, Alex. I'm really glad you talked me into it. It was a lot of fun.
Of course.
It's kind of crazy that you knew exactly what would cheer me up. So, what are you gonna do now?
What do you mean?
That shit with Mac. He's clearly lying, right?
I'm not sure what Mac's deal is. His story doesn't add up.
Yeah.
I do know that I need to find out exactly what happened that night. For myself and for Gabe.
I've got your back, no matter what.
Thank you. That means a lot.
I should head back to work.
Cool.
Bye.
Bye.
Is she okay?
Hey, I'm glad you stopped by. I've only got a sec, but...
Oh, awesome!
Have you talked to Ethan at all?
Talked is maybe too strong a word. I tried.
He's taking it really hard. But what you did for me this morning got me thinking. What if Ethan needs something like that too? Something fun and distracting. Something like a LARP.
Like the one you and Gabe were gonna take him to?
Yeah, but designed just for him and Thaynor.
He'll love that.
Yeah, I'm glad you think so. I need your help, though. I want it to be as good as it can be. Ethan gave you one of his comics, right? So, what do you think? Who would the famous Monster Slayer have the most fun defeating?
Cravius looks pretty badass. Go with that.
All right, then. Oh, I gotta get back in there. There's some stuff in my comp book.
Be cool if you could check it out. Help me make some calls.
I'll see what I can do.
This one's for you, Gabe. I miss you.
I didn't speak this morning. I couldn't. Hearing everyone talk about him, about the life he had here with all of you, I lost the chance to have that. But even though I only had one day with him, he changed my life. I said, I didn't know if I belonged here. He told me that home isn't something you find. It's something you build.
You have a superpower? You're both fucking with me, right?
Do Ryan and I look like the fucking with you type? It's all true.
Fine. Then tell me what I'm feeling right now.
You're feeling disbelief.
You're actually a little annoyed. You feel hurt that we didn't tell you until now. Whether it's true or not, you don't like being left out.
Well, okay. Oh, shit. the foosball game. You knew exactly what to do.
You needed to focus on the positive memories, not get lost in the sadness. I thought it would help.
It did. Just warn me next time, okay?
Deal.
Never thought I'd have a freaky empath friend. Pretty wild.
So, any sign of Diane today?
No. But she was in yesterday working on her laptop.
You said she was afraid of something around Gabe's death. If she's covering up what Typhon did, I bet there's proof.
I hope so. If she comes in today, let's be ready with a plan. In the meantime, I've got to finish my shift.
We're on it.
You have a superpower? You're both fucking with me, right?
I'm not so into calling it a superpower, but all the rest is true.
Fine. Then tell me what I'm feeling right now.
You're feeling disbelief.
You're actually a little annoyed. You feel hurt that we didn't tell you until now. Whether it's true or not, you don't like being left out.
Well, okay. Oh, shit. The foosball game. You knew exactly what to do.
You needed to focus on the positive memories, not get lost in the sadness. I thought it would help.
It did. Just warn me next time, okay?
Deal.
Never thought I'd have a freaky empath friend. Pretty wild.
So, any sign of Diane today?
No. But she was in yesterday working on her laptop.
You said she was afraid of something around Gabe's death. If she's covering up what Typhon did, I bet there's proof.
I hope so. If she comes in today, let's be ready with a plan. In the meantime, I've got to finish my shift.
We're on it.
Okay, she's here. What's the plan?
Well, we have two plans, actually. But we're still workshopping them.
What does workshopping mean, exactly?
It means Ryan won't admit that my plan is perfect. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. I asked Diane out on a date.
Wait, what?
And she's so into it. She doesn't notice one Ryan Lucan swiping her laptop. Ryan carries said laptop upstairs, acquiring damning evidence. Maybe Diane and I still hook up? Not important.
That's your plan? Oh my God, please tell me you have something better.
I do. Now to be clear, it's the same plan. Except, I'm the distraction. Look, Steph, I don't even think she's gay, all right? She's probably into the rugged mountain man type. All the transplants are.
I'm genuinely worried that these were the best ideas you had.
What? It's a simple plan, literally two steps. You just need to choose the hotter distraction.
Okay, I'm not doing that.
You're the only tiebreaker we have.
let's go with Steph. Badass DJ? It's a no-brainer. Sorry, Ryan.
Fuck yes. In your face.
Yeah, that's fair.
Look, I appreciate the effort, but we don't even know if she has anything worth stealing yet. I'm just gonna try talking to her. Maybe I can get her worked up and read her emotions. I'll let you know if I need that distraction.
Good luck.
Hey, Diane.
Oh, hey, Steph. How are you?
So, what's your deal?
I'm sorry?
Are you single? Semi-single? Taken, but still down to get drunk and make out?
Whoa. Was not expecting that at all. Am I blushing? I feel like I'm blushing.
Yeah, I could see your cheeks from space.
Super. Real good look for me. I'm so flattered. I don't even know what to say.
Hey, no sweat. Just think about it. Get back to me. I'm not going anywhere.
See ya.
My heart is pounding.
Steph, there's a very real chance that you awoke something in Diane.
Wouldn't be the first time.
You guys, that was hilarious. Oh my God. I hope this was worth it.
Sorry about the lock. These are dangerous times. Welcome to the Magpie Emporium.
Oh, so this is like a magic shop.
I'm gonna take a look around a bit, okay?
Okay.
Yeah? When Alex said I'm hot, did she mean it? Or was she just messing around?
Never seen Steph feel this way before. Maybe I could reassure her. She's always so confident.
Maybe.
Would you consider giving us that sapphire? In exchange for something far more valuable. My hand. In marriage. And all of its associated benefits. And you should know, I wouldn't offer if I didn't mean it.
I mean...
Oh, man. This just got real.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't intrigued, but I'm afraid I can't accept. For now.
We need the sapphire right away. It's for a quest to end the age of monsters.
I've heard there's a magical fish that lives in the River of Sorrows. Bring me back one of its scales, and I'll give you the sapphire in return.
one magic fish scale.
Impressive. Well, then here's my end of the bargain. I do.
Maybe when Ethan's not around.
Test, test. Check, check. Holy shit, you own a skirt?
Hey, guys.
Happy first Spring Fest.
Thanks. I got a hold of Pike. He'll be here soon. Once he sees what's on that stick, it's over for Typhon.
Hence the celebration. I think we've all earned the right to enjoy ourselves a little tonight.
The band's coming on soon. You'd better be front and center.
Oh, rad. Do you need help setting up for the show?
Nah, it's all good. We're almost there.
I have to run back to the trailer. Go be a normal person for a while.
Can't make any promises. Text me when it's ready. Is for you.
Are you serious?
Of course I am.
Dude, thank you so much. This totally makes my night.
I'm glad.
Hey, could we meet up after the show tonight? I actually have some pretty big news to share. She said mysteriously.
Of course.
Speaking of, Ryan should be done any minute. Meet me there?
Sure.
Hey, just in time.
So, who's playing?
Yours truly.
Seriously? That's awesome! Well, wait, who else? Who else is playing? I hate you both.
We didn't want you to wuss out.
Who said anything about wussing out?
Nobody, but only because we didn't give you the opportunity.
This is gonna be awesome. Trust me.
We've never played together before, and, anyway, sorry if this sucks. Fuck it.
I'm messed up and I'm so strung out. I'm high as a kite and I just might stop to check you out. Let me go on, I got this tour in the sun.
I was horrible to you earlier.
You really weren't.
Really? Then I fucked up because I was trying pretty hard to be horrible to you. I was so excited about you coming to Haven. In my mind, the way I built it up, we were gonna be best friends. I wish...
There's still time.
Maybe. I guess we'll see. No, but, you know, I'm gonna go home.
Like Steph wants to meet me on the rooftop.
Okay, I gotta admit, this is a pretty great feeling.
You said you have some news?
I'm leaving. I'm actually leaving Haven Springs. Can you believe it? Back on the road again. Fucking finally.
Wait, seriously?
I'm gonna play music again, Alex. Anywhere I want. God, I forgot how fucking good it feels.
I don't know what to say. I want to be supportive, but...
Hey, come on. No time to be sad. We've got work to do. I need a new destination. You're my good luck charm.
You have shit taste in good luck charms.
Shut up. Pick one. Salem, Halloween capital of the world, or so they say. Who do I hang out with?
What if you infiltrate a group of Massachusetts bros? Hang out in a dank bar until 2, shouting "Go Sox" at the TV?
You know what? Yeah, that sounds wicked rad. Get real tough and edgy. Really integrate into the whole scene.
You start challenging dudes twice your size to drinking contests. You never lose, obviously. That sounds like a pretty spectacular plan.
Great. Then come with me.
To Salem?
Sure, why not? Doesn't have to be our first stop, but one day. I still have friends in Seattle who book shows. Maybe we start there, or, I don't know, Kansas City, Vegas, wherever we want. Look, I don't want to pressure you, but I've seen you give so much of yourself to make sure other people get what they need. And I guess I wonder if you've thought about what you need. I mean, obviously, I like you a lot, Alex. You mean the fucking world to me. Kiss me. Don't have to decide anything now, okay? Just think about it.
I will. Thank you.
I'm gonna head back down. Find me later.
During my time here, I've come to realize what makes Haven so special.
It's a flower shop run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer by name. It's a spring festival tradition going back 100 years. History, loyalty, pride. These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful. It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven. We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Thank you, Diane. I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks, and then lunch.
God,
I'm fine.
You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
I found out something you need to hear. I'm sorry.
What?
Alex, you're hurt. Do you need help? We can call an ambulance.
Typhon's been lying to all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Alex, what's going on?
You know exactly what's going on. I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years. Jed Lucan isn't a hero. That whole story is a lie. Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up in case it jeopardized the vote. Everyone at that company is scared to death. All they do is protect themselves. So they decided to bury the evidence. And nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were 4 people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too. Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
I wasn't asking you.
The things you've said obligate me to at least address them. These accusations are, well, they're insane. And trying to go into the mine was obviously, a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do. But we all sympathize with your situation. You've been through so much. Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss. Something to give you comfort and make your life seem less unfair.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad? Do you have any idea what Alex is talking about?
No. I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died. I thought, I don't know, I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her. All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
You tried to kill me. How can you stand there and say these things?
Alex.
You're a monster. Please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too. But I'm telling the truth.
I believe you. Of course I do. I believe you too. I'm horrified and shocked and still processing everything, but I believe you.
Miss Harmon, please remember the terms of your settlement.
Screw your settlement. I would never take that money.
Charlotte, please. I would like to speak. I've known Jed a very, very long time. And, Miss Chen? Alex? I'm realizing I don't quite know you as well as I thought. Some allowances must, of course, be made given your injuries and resultant confusion. But nonetheless, it saddens me to hear you make these terrible and incredible accusations against my friend.
Ducky, that's enough. Don't let him make you feel bad, sweetheart. No one here thinks you're a bad person. You know our mind can play tricks on us. None of it is your fault. It's so hard to admit you need help. But struggling alone... No. You shouldn't have to go through that. We're all worried about you. Let us help you.
Don't worry, Alex. I got this.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I have a USB stick full of recordings.
Yes, we went through this yesterday. Your superiors closed the case. None of us have time for conspiracies.
Yeah. You're trying to weasel your way out of things again, huh? I know your game. I know.
Don't test me, Jason.
You know what? I'm not scared of you anymore. And not of you. Not Typhon.
All right, that's enough.
Deputy Pike, do you have some kind of personal issue with me?
Like hell I do.
Jason. Well, given that your judgment in this matter is emotionally compromised, you should probably remove yourself from...
Oh, cut the crap. If you think you could shut me up...
Jason, I think you better cool it.
I would like to speak again.
It concerns me that a voting member of this council has openly admitted...
You believe me.
...personal bias,
this
right?
This is a load of bullshit.
I don't believe... believe this. Getting ridiculous.
Ryan?
Getting ahead of ourselves.
Why are you doing this?
I'm not your lapdog anymore.
Deputy Pike, I am not responsible for any frustrations you...
My dad is not a murderer. Were you afraid we couldn't get Typhon? Is that why you need someone else to blame? I thought we were in this together. For Gabe.
Ryan.
No. I'm not gonna let you do that to me anymore.
Ryan, what the hell? I know he's your dad, but look at her. Why would she lie about this?
It's going too far.
Alex almost died.
It's not true.
Fuck you, Ryan! After everything? Seriously, fuck you!
Stop. I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John. The world never gave him anything for free. He fought just to stay alive. He fought for us. Maybe he was finally winning. But you killed him. And then Gabe, my big brother. He was building a family here, doing it his own way, figuring it out as he went along. He was so nervous about it, and so excited. And he brought me here to be part of that family. But he died. Because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive. To get through. Haven changed me. I started to think about the future. I want to help people. Because it's something I'm good at. Knowing I'm good at something feels fucking great. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth. Forgotten it, haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero, a strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices. Decisions that could lead to people dying.
Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Eleven years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And you couldn't even say those words out loud because you're a coward. You couldn't imagine saying it to your wife, saying it in front of your son. Every day you were brave enough to go underground and look death in the eye. But you couldn't muster the courage to admit a mistake. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't. The truth hurts. Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. I see the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows. I know who you are. I've seen the worst parts of you. And I forgive you. Steph.
Alex, wait. Before you say anything, I have to get this out.
Okay.
What you did at the council meeting, it was the bravest thing I've ever seen. And it made me want to be brave too. So, here it goes. I want to be with you. I don't give a shit about playing music or seeing the world. I mean, I do, but only if it's with you. And if you'd rather stay here instead, then... fuck it. I want to stay here too.
You ripped your bus ticket.
I can get another one. Or not. It doesn't matter. Point is, I'm in. For whatever you want.
You've, given me a lot to think about.
Well, good. That was the idea. You know where to find me. Good luck, Chen.
Thanks, Steph. All right, just tell me.
What?
my future. What to do? The night of the Spring Fest, Steph made a strong push for leaving with her. Playing on the road, the excitement of the unknown. Of course, that was before all the shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
You really think so?
Of course. You finally have a home, a job, people who actually like you. Why would you give that up?
That's true.
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off. Stop it, Gabe. I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
And here's something. It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. And neither is Steph. Life goes on. You get a job working with Steph at the record store. All those years of being a music snob finally pay off. And little by little, time does its thing. The apartment starts to feel less like a museum and more like a home. Thoughts of Jed, of Typhon, even of me, begin to fade into the background. Thank you.
rooftop is your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans. Maybe while you play, you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all. You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you. And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it. You don't doubt it. Or wonder what might have been. It's your life. The life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
I know what I want. Hello, everyone. I'm Alex Chen.